Letterland. Beats Slithering Sam, a king who can kick a quarrelsome queen or mean noisy Nick. So let's go to Letterland. Let's go to Letterland today.
Look, guys, there's a friend who wants to help do Letterland today. Do you want to help? Yeah? All right, let's move on to our next Red Robot blends. So we have Dippy Duck and Red Robot. And what do these two say together?
Drrr.
That's right. They say drrr when they're together. If you remember back to that Red Robot story that I was telling you about the Billy Goats and Red Robot and how Red Robot likes to try to steal the sound still, drrr is one of those that he does still try to steal the sound from. So you have to listen really carefully to hear the d sound in the words that have the drrr blend.
Dippy Duck and Red Robot. Dippy Duck says d, and Red Robot says r. Together they say dr, in drum and dress and drink.
Yeah, so Dippy Duck and Red Robot, like I said, you have to listen really carefully for that r sound, for that d sound, because in drink, we sometimes might miss that duh sound and just hear rink, but really it's drink, right? Practice saying a couple of those words with the dr blend. Okay. Let's go back to stretching and spelling out a word with the dr blend right at first, okay? So let's use one of our word families that we should know pretty well. Let's use the op family and let's spell out the word drop, okay? Say that word, drop. Like when raindrops fall from the sky. Let's warm up those stretchy rubber band hands and stretch out drop. Did you guys hear all the sounds in the word? Maybe one more time. Drop. Okay, let's tap them out to see if we hear all the sounds. Drop. I think I heard them all. Did you? If you need to tap them out again, go ahead. Awesome. I'm going to go ahead and drag down our dr blend, because since we're practicing with that, we know that those two come first. And then in my tapping, what sound came third in that letter? So we had d, r, ah. That's right. Who makes that ah sound? Oscar Orange. And then who makes the sound at the end of the word drop? That's right, Peter Puppy. Okay, this looks really good, but I'm always going to double check and read that word to make sure that it spells out the word drop. D-r-op. Drop. 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 Does this spell drop? Yes, it does. Excellent work. For this next dr blend word, let's get some practice with that magic E. So let's spell out the word drape. Can you say drape? See how Red Robot comes in and he tries to steal Dippy Duck sound? It does get really tricky to hear those two sounds in a word. Drape is something that hangs from a window. It can be like a curtain that covers the window, or if you want to drape, you can drape something over, like my hand is draped over my arm. Let's spell out the word drape. So first, we're gonna stretch out that word, drape. One more time, drape. Good job. Now let's tap out the sounds in that word, drape. Who do you guys hear? What vowel man? Who's screaming his name? Mr. A. That's right. So I'm going to drag down Mr. A. I'm going to put him right there. So now I've got dr A. And then who makes the next sound? Dr A. P. P. That's right. It's Peter Puppy. If I leave the word like this, Peter Puppy's ears are going to hurt. His ears that droop down, they're going to hurt so bad because Mr. A is screaming his name. So I need to drag Magic E. Ooh, my favorite part with the sparkles. I need to drag Magic E down here to the end of the word so that Magic E can sprinkle his sparkles over Peter Puppy. And we can still hear Mr. A, and Peter Puppy's ears won't hurt. Let's read back this word to see if it spells out drape. Dr-ape. Good job. Dr-ape. Yes, it does spell out drape. Awesome. Let's go on to our next Red Robot blend with Firefighter Fred. This blend says
fur.
Fur, right? Can you think of a word that has the fur blend in it? I can. It's one of my favorite words, friends. And remember, Red Robot, that sneaky little sneaker Red Robot, is trying to steal that sound away. So you've got to make sure friends, when you're stretching out the fur blend for your writing, you're really listening to hear those sounds in that word. A lot of us, when we're stretching out the fur blend, also get a little bit confused and think that it's Talking Tess and Harry Hatman, like not liking the thunder, right? So when we're stretching out the fur words, we want to make sure that we feel where our teeth are, like say thunder, right? Your tongue comes right under your teeth, thunder. But when I say friends, my teeth kind of come on top of my lip. So I know that that's really, really tricky to hear, but think about what you're saying, whether it's a sound or a fur sound, okay?
Firefighter Fred and Red Robot. Firefighter Fred says f, and Red Robot says r. Together, they say fur. In Frog and Fruit and Friends.
Yep, there's our favorite word. And I also love fruit. What about you guys? Let's spell out some words with our fur blend, okay? So we're going to drag f and r down to the reading direction arrow because we know that our word will start with that. Let's start with a Magic E practice word, okay? I want us to spell out the word frame. Everybody say frame. That's right. We hear Magic E in that word, or we know that we hear Magic E, because who else do we hear in that word? Let's figure it out, okay? Frame. Good job. Stretch it out one more time. Frame. Wow. I think that I heard every sound, but I'm going to tap just to make sure. Frame. Awesome. I know that after fur comes
A.
Mr. A, because I heard fur A and then Who makes that sound? Our pal, Munching Mike. And we know that there's a Magic E, because otherwise Munching Mike's ears would really hurt, and Mr. A doesn't want to do that to Munching Mike. So I think we've got all of our letters. Let's get out our roller coaster and stretch this word out to see if we spelled it. Frame. Frame. Yes, good job, you guys. Let's practice reading a fur blend word. So I've got the word down here on my reading arrow, my reading direction arrow, and I see that I've got the fur blend at the front, and I see that Sammy Snake has slid up behind Harry Hatman, and Harry Hatman has turned around and said, sh. That's right. So I've got fur at the beginning and sh at the end. Does this letter in the middle say eh or e? If you said eh, you're exactly correct. This letter in the middle is not Mr. E because we don't see a vowel team and we don't see magic E at the end. So we know that that's Eddie Elephant there in that word. Let's get out our roller coaster and stretch this word out. Fur, eh, shh. One more time. Fur, eh, shh. Fresh, fresh. Good job. If you said fresh, you got it.